Gilbert O'Sullivan for Donna this morning. 9:31, showers, but clearing later, turning colder, and it's doing that as we speak. 7 degrees due to the high winds and rough seas. Marine Atlantic has been forced to cancel the sailings of the Marine Atlantic, Princess of Acadia, the St. John sailing, and the Digby sailing. 10 o'clock this morning and 2:30 this afternoon have been canceled. The next scheduled crossing will leave St. John at midnight. And they're down to one ferry at Condola Point. Had to shut the other one down because of the high winds. And they're playing it by ear. We'll keep you apprised of the goings-on with the ferry situation throughout the day because of the high winds. 9:32. Johnny Preston next.
It's big. It's here. And it's on right now. It's Leon's Canada-wide Boxing Week sale. Come in today and take advantage of store-wide savings as far as the eye can see.
Save 40% on a genuine black leather sofa, love seat, and chair.
Yes, it's the biggest savings event of the year. Plus, there's nothing to pay until 1998. That's right. Absolutely no interest and no payments. Not in 96, not in 97, not till 1998. Leon's store-wide Boxing Week sale. You'll kick yourself if you miss it.
Leon.
Are where it's at, sticks and babe. 9:43, overcast conditions, cooling off considerably throughout the weekend, more seasonable values after the mild streak, should get down to minus 11 for the overnight low tonight, and a few flurries blowing around. If you're going out partying tonight, be careful with all the rain and the temperature plummeting. We could have some slick or greasy roads, so be extra careful.
See again for the Byway Times, and it's time you came to Byway. Because those other stores are fa-la-la compared to our prices. Like 20% off all sweaters for men, ladies, and kids. 50% off all Christmas wrapping paper. And deck your halls with this deal. Byway's taking 50% off all tree trimming and Christmas decor, and 30% off all Christmas linens. So make your list, but just check it once, because Byway's the only place you need to go this Christmas. Come to Byway now. Byway, 35 years of great Christmas deals.
9:49, all request hour. We'll put the wrappers on it now. Talk of the Town is coming up at 10 o'clock. Nicole Bardot with the news in about 6 minutes. Well, it's my last deal until January the 2nd. I'd like to take this time to wish you and your family all the best of the holiday season, and we hope to see you back here January the 2nd. Merry Christmas from my family to yours. And on behalf of Patty McDougal, who's working in the control room today, she would like to wish her husband, Dave, and all the firefighters in St. John a Merry Christmas. This is Donnie in the Morning, St. John. Thank you.
Every boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. On Christmas Day.
Where the news watch never stops.
It's 1 degree at 9:55, gradual clearing today. Good morning, I'm Nicole Bardell, and this is CFBC News. Education Minister Jim Lockyer says it's important for people involved in the school system to know their responsibilities. That is a major part of a proposed Education Act that Lockyer has made public. He says it's important to outline the duties of teachers, parents, and children.
Good morning. Here's your exclusive precision weather forecast here this afternoon. It'll turn colder, too, as temperatures drop to near zero. West to northwesterly winds will increase to 30 to 50 during the midday. Evening flurries, then turning clear tonight, minus 11. West to northwesterlies, 15 to 25, diminish. Lots of sunshine tomorrow, high temperatures only minus 2. Westerlies at 15 to 25. Forecast for Sunday, cloudy with a few flurries and high temperatures near plus 1. From the Skywatch Weather Center, this is meteorologist Russ Murley.
In the city, it's 1 degree at 10 o'clock. Our next low tide is at 20 past 2. I'm Nicole Bardow, and this is CFBC, your number one news source.
This is CFBC's Talk of the Town with Gary McDonald. Locally, call 658-2322. Or from anywhere in Atlantic Canada, call 1-800-561-8255. That's 1-800-561-TALK. Here's Gary.
And a very good Friday morning, everyone. Just before we get down to the business, I linked some people up long distance. And they can exchange some holiday greetings. And we have some letters here and really kind of some neat stories along the way. So we'll be talking to those folks and also making the long-distance calls on their behalf. And in between, if we have the opportunity, we invite your calls, too. And let's just talk about Christmas, what your plans are for Christmas, and how your Christmas shopping is going, whether or not you're ready. If you have any sort of neat Christmas traditions, so we'll be doing a little bit of everything this morning. A Christmassy show, though, our long-distance Christmas show. Then coming up on Monday, we are going to be doing our Christmas music request show, and you can send your favorite Christmas music out to your friends, family, and, you know, relatives, anyone at all, on Monday. And I'll have a special guest or two in the studio with me come Monday. In addition, on Tuesday is our annual visit from Santa Claus, and Santa Claus will be calling as many people as possible on our list, and we have a very long list, so we will try and get as many of those calls placed as possible on Tuesday. But before we get down to the business of the long-distance show, the winds are wreaking havoc in the Sussex area. All schools in District 4 will be closing early today. A school official tells CFBC News they're running on a half-day procedure. That means everything will shut down 3 hours ahead of their normal schedule. Quite a few schools in District 4 are still without power this morning. The wind's playing havoc with power down around Mesa's Bay. I'm told they've had some power outages as well. So in the Sussex area, schools are closing early. They're running on a half-day procedure. That means everything will shut down 3 hours ahead of normal schedule. All right, it is a long-distance show this morning, and we do have some letters, some folks who would like to talk to people across the country and partway around the world this morning, long distance, to say a very Merry Christmas to their loved ones and friends. So when we come back, we'll be placing our very first call.
The manager and staff of the Baptist Book Room would like to extend Christmas blessings to you and your family. May the gift of Jesus and his love visit you afresh as you humble your heart to receive him this Christmas season. Thank you for your continued patronage, and may God's blessing be yours in the coming new year. Remember that the Baptist Book Room in Loch Lomond Mall has beautiful Christmas gift items at 25% savings to help warm a family or friend's heart.
When it comes to pricing, they don't take a strip off your hide. Leatherware will surprise Christmas shoppers with their amazing low pricing on quality leatherware. Like biker jackets starting at $149, Western boots from $93.45, 20% savings on all Western hats, oilskin starting at $169, and the saving doesn't end there. Leatherware will even pay the PST on all regular prices. In-store specials galore. What a store! Leatherware in Parkway and Fredericton Malls.
Oldies 93 CFBC proudly presents Sarita's Wedding Show, Wednesday, January 22nd at the St. John Trade and Convention Center. A breathtaking bridal fashion show with many sponsors showcasing their products. If your business has something to offer newlyweds and you'd like more information on having a display, just say I do. Call Kelly Thorne at 649-7116. That's 649-7116. Sarita's Wedding Show, presented by Oldies 93 CFBC.
Don't let anything stop you from taking home Colonial Imports' unbelievable offer. Brand new...
On the line right now is Darlene.
And staff of the Baptist Book Room would like to extend Christmas blessings to you and your family. May the gift of Jesus and his love visit you afresh as you humble your heart to receive him this Christmas season. Thank you for your continued patronage, and may God's blessing be yours in the coming new year. Remember that the Baptist Book Room in Loch Lomond Mall has beautiful Christmas gift items at 25% savings to help warm a family or friend's heart.
When it comes to pricing, they don't take a strip off your hide. Leatherware will surprise Christmas shoppers with their amazing low pricing on quality leatherware. Like biker jackets starting at $149, Western boots from $93.45, 20% savings on all Western hats, oilskin starting at $169, and the saving doesn't end there. Leatherware will even pay the PST on all regular prices. In-store specials galore. What a store! Leatherware in Parkway and Fredericton Malls.
Oldies 93 CFBC proudly presents Sarita's Wedding Show, Wednesday, January 22nd at the St. John Trade and Convention Center. A breathtaking bridal fashion show with many sponsors showcasing their products. If your business has something to offer newlyweds and you'd like more information on having a display, just say I do. Call Kelly Thorne at 649-7116. That's 649-7116. Sarita's Wedding Show, presented by Oldies 93 CFBC.
Don't let anything stop you from taking home Colonial Imports' unbelievable offer. Brand new...
On the line right now is Darlene McCrazy. Morning, Darlene.
Okay.
Now, Darlene, you're at work, I know. Where do you work?
At NCH Promotional.
Uh-huh.
Someplace?
Yes.
Keep using your coupons, folks.
Okay, yeah, that's right. And you'll stay employed, right?
That's right.
Okay, Darlene, who do you want to call and why?
I want to talked to my cousin, Karen. She's in Goose Bay, Labrador.
Now you know.
Now I know.
He sounds like he's in very good spirits, and so did she.
Oh, Karen, top drawer anyway.
Mm-hmm. All right. Darlene, you have a very Merry Christmas.
You too, you and your family.
And thank you for listening.
Thank you.
All right, bye-bye. Well, there you go. There's our first long-distance call, and isn't that kind of a neat scenario in the fact that the people she was calling, Darlene wanted to call, was happened to be one of the four people on board that rescue helicopter that went down while on a rescue mission. And these guys were among the missing for, I think, 4 or 5 days, if I remember correctly. And they all came out of it okay. A little worse for the wear, but when you listen to Scott, you know, boy, when you consider the way it could have been, what a great Christmas gift. And that was really kind of a neat call to hear him and talking a bit about it and everything. And that's what we're doing this morning. We're doing some long-distance calls. We have some folks who have written in and said, okay, we have some people we'd really like to talk to. And that's what we're going to be doing throughout the program. However, in the meantime, as well, we welcome your calls. We'd like to know about what you're doing for Christmas this year, because this is the last show before the big day, other than our special shows. Monday, we'll do our Christmas music request show. And, of course, Tuesday, the big one, where we have Santa Claus in studio and we're calling all of the little ones or as many little ones as possible. So I want to know what you're doing for Christmas. It's also... I start my vacation as of today, but I'll be in to do the two shows, the shows on Monday and Tuesday, just the talk shows, because I have fun doing those shows, and I wanted to do them, so I'll continue and do those, but this is pretty much it. I'm on vacation for 2 weeks, so I want to know what you're doing for Christmas, if you have any special plans, if you're going to be out on the weekend like I am, doing last-minute Christmas, you know, rubbing elbows for the crowds and everything. I want to say a very special thank you as well to Mary Cormier. Is that right, Andy, if I can make out your writing? Is she responsible for the goodies in there? And I notice you're keeping them in there with you.
They're going to be gone at noon. That's what's
going to
happen.
I know. I'm going to sit here and watch you fill your face. But you should have a roasting pan full of
the cake there and homemade cookies and squares and bonbons.
Like,
and
are those Nanaimo squares?
I'm not going to know what I'm going to let you know in a couple of minutes when I take my fork.
No, I want to find out myself because I love that's like shortbread cooking. Nanaimo squares happen to be one of my downfalls. Okay, when we come back, we'll do some more phone calls. In the meantime, we want to hear from you, too. Morning. And, hey, if you want to pass along a Merry Christmas, then feel free to give us a call. Tell me what you're doing this morning. Okay, we are doing our long-distance show, and we have some more long-distance calls to make in the second hour. Plus, we want to talk to you this morning to find out what you're doing for Christmas and if you have any sort of unique Christmas traditions and all of those sorts of things. That's coming up in the second hour of Talk of the Town.
This is CFBC, where the news watch never stops.
It's 1 degree, yes, 1055, gradual clearing today. Good morning, I'm Nicole Bardow, and this is CFBC News. Well, the winds are wreaking havoc in the Sussex area today. All schools in District 4 will be closing early. The school official tells CFBC News they are running on a half-day procedure. Now, that means everything will shut down 3 hours ahead of normal schedule. Quite a few schools in District 4 are still without power this morning. Well, here in the city, the weather is causing problems for the Irvings today. Champlain Heights Irving is off limits to customers due to some structure damage. A big canopy over the pump has let go, lights and everything. Even one of the pumps is knocked off the block due to high winds. Crews are on the scene trying to fix the situation. Well, due to the high winds and rough seas, the folks at Marine Atlantic have been forced to alter their schedule between St. John and Digby. The 10 o'clock sailing out of St. John was canceled, and the 2:30 from Digby has been canceled as well. Next scheduled crossing now leaves St. John at midnight. In other news today, the Landfill Commission has received approval to borrow between $18 and $19 million so it can build a facility. Municipal Capital Borrowing Board approved the request yesterday, paving the way to buy the land at Crane Mountain and putting the money in the account for other items. Chair Danny Harrigan says it's just in time, considering they have to buy the property at Crane Mountain by the end of the month.
We need it for December 30th. You know, we have it. It gives us a couple of weeks to arrange our financing now with a financial institution. So
just in time.
We're happy.
As for the expropriating of the covenants on the land, Harrigan says it'll probably be the new year before that's done. The commission executive is again talking about the city's veto power over money.
Very Merry Christmas to all of you.
Thank you very much, now.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Oh, that was really neat now to Australia. And it's about 2 o'clock in the morning in Australia right now. 2 o'clock on Saturday morning as well. They're ahead of us on the dateline. 2 o'clock in the morning. I always get confused chatting to people on the net in Australia, especially when they start coming up with, you know, the day and boy. Anyway, that's nice that those folks had the opportunity to link up, even though it was somewhat of a surprise at 2 o'clock in the morning, but that's what it's all about. We have one more call we're going to try and squeeze in when we come back.
As you share this holiday season with the ones you care about, remember that the management and staff of Brockdale Brews and Natural Foods thank you for your support and look forward to serving you again in the new year. May your Christmas be merry and bright.
Season's greetings from the management and staff of Campbell Stillwell Residential Services. They would like to thank their customers for their support through 1996 and look forward to serving you again in 1997. Campbell Stillwell, built on tradition, working for the future.
Wrap it up for Christmas with Sears half-price specials and great buys. All home electronics, major appliances, and furniture are on sale. Use your Sears card to qualify for no payments till 1998. Microwave ovens, dishwashers, ranges, vacuum cleaners, sewing machines, personal stereos, sleep sets, it's all on sale. Save 50% on Sears Christmas trees, lights, and decorations. Sears in McAllister Place. Open tonight till 11 and tomorrow morning till 8:30, where you get your money's worth and more.
Christmas is about the young and the young at heart. But most of all, it's about the spirit of giving. Season's greetings to our friends and customers from the management and staff of Teledirect Yellow Pages. May you have a safe and happy holiday.
Parkway Mercury has an incredible deal on remaining 96s. Till the end of the month only, get 2.9 APR on all 96 Mercury cars and Ford trucks. But hurry, it's all over December 31st at Parkway Mercury, Westmoreland Road, St. John. Nobody sells for less. Nobody.
When it comes to pricing, they don't take a strip off your hide. Leatherware will surprise Christmas shoppers with their amazing low pricing on quality leatherware. Like biker jackets starting at $149, Western boots from $93.45, 20% savings on all Western hats, oilskin starting at $169, and the saving doesn't end there. Leatherware will even pay the PST on all regular prices. In-store specials galore. What a store! Leatherware in Parkway and Fredericton Malls.
Christmas is a very special, very festive, joyous occasion. Join Oldies 93 CFBC between noon and 6 Sunday for Christmas Is. 6 full hours of heartwarming Christmas music, short Christmas features, historical vignettes, Yuletide readings, and holiday humor. Christmas Is, Sunday from noon till 6 on Oldies 93 CFBC. Brought to you by Thistle St. Andrews Curling Club, Dominion Refuse Collectors and St. John Recycling, and Child's Restaurant and Lounge.
Hi, this is Josie from Carmella's Coffee and Donuts, Main Street in Hampton. I'd like to wish all of our friends, family, and customers the most joyous holiday season, and we look forward to serving you in the new year.
Okay, let's go back to Joan on the Golden Grove Road. Hi, Joan.
Hi.
We're going to give this another try. We have time for just a quick call anyway. Here we go. To Harris, D.C., I believe. No, 100 Mile House.
Yeah.
Yeah. Boy, imagine me now piloting the plane. For the purpose of voting on the latest contract offer, all members in good standing are urged to attend by order of the negotiators.
It's a happy time of year. How would you like to relax amidst a roaring fire in an atmosphere so stunning it will make you catch your breath? P.J. Billington's in Hotel Courtney Bay is a truly remarkable restaurant. P.J. Billington's has put out the welcome mat, and is waiting to book your holiday parties and gatherings. A buffet for 50? PJ Billington's knows how to satisfy. PJ Billington's open 7 days a week in Hotel Courtney Bay.
Appliance Sales and Service on Ross A. Avenue.
I want to thank everyone for calling in this morning. I want to thank the folks who wrote in with their long-distance requests. Certainly some interesting conversations, and we were all over the world this morning from the West Coast straight to Australia. Really very neat. And Monday, it is our Christmas music request show. Tuesday, ho-ho, and then it's the big day itself. Have a great weekend out there Christmas shopping. Catch you back Monday morning at 10.
This has been Talk of the Town, heard weekdays between 10 a.m. and 12 noon on Oldies 93 CFBC. The opinions expressed are not necessarily those of the station owners, management, or its advertisers. This is CFBC, where the news watch never stops.
It's 1 degree at 11:56. We have some gradual clearing today. Those winds will die down. Good morning, I'm Nicole Bardell, and this is CFBC News. Well, the wind is causing some real problems here in the city. Early this morning, downed power lines along Bayside Drive created some havoc during the rush hour. Civic Hydro reports 6 broken poles around the city, and they have resulted in some isolated power outages. Strong winds whipped up waves crashing over the Redhead Dyke. Champlain Heights Irving is off limits to customers due to some structure damage. The underside of a big canopy over the pumps has let go, lights and everything. Even one of the pumps was knocked off the block due to the high winds. Irving spokesman Paul Quayle says when the wind got under the metal, they evacuated the parking lot. CFBC, your only choice for breaking news. And now Russ Merling, CFBC Precision Weather.
Here's your exclusive Precision Weather forecast. Gradual clearing as we roll through the afternoon. Those winds will remain strong, though. Could see some gusts in excess of 80 kilometers per hour. Temperatures will be slowly falling to near zero. Tonight evening flurries, then turning clear and cold, minus 11. West to northwesterlies will diminish to 10 to 20 by daybreak. Considerable sunshine, minus 2 tomorrow. Westerlies 15 to 25. And cloudy with flurries, plus 1 on Sunday. From the Skywatch Weather Center, this is meteorologist Russ Merling.
In the city, it's 1 degree at 12 o'clock. Our next low tide at 20 past 2. I'm Nicole Bardell, and this is CFBC, your number one news source.
It's the best oldies with Andy to move your workday along.
Oh, this is simply ideal.
On Oldies 93, CFBC.
Round, round, get around, I get around.
So all the right seasons.
It's plus 1 degree with a wind chill of minus 11 in the high winds at noon hour. I'm Brian McLean. This is K100 News for the Mediterranean on Rothsay Avenue. It's as close as you'll get to the Mediterranean on your lunch hour, the Mediterranean restaurants on Rothsay Avenue. The high winds indeed are causing problems in the area. In Sussex, schools in District 4 we'll be closing 3 hours early because of downed power lines, and this has resulted in more schools being left without power than with power. District 4 is instituting its normal half-day procedure for discharging students. The high winds also forcing a number of school closures in the Fredericton area. In District 18, the Marysville schools, Stanley Elementary and Stanley High School, are all closed. In District 17, Gessner, Assiniboine, Hubbard Avenue, Harold Peterson, and Cambridge Narrows are closed. The Princess of Acadia has canceled its crossings today. The next scheduled departure is from St. John at midnight. Civic Hydro reporting 6 downed hydro poles, and they've had problems at the Champlain Heights Irving. NB Power says there are close to 200 interruptions throughout the province, affecting more than 20,000 customers. Police are warning truck drivers with empty trailers not to travel across the Tantramar Marsh between Sackville and Amherst. A tavern in Amherst lost part of its roof in the high winds, while a restaurant had a satellite dish blown off. And a Marine Atlantic ferry with 116 passengers and 20 crew members on board has gone aground just off Borden PEI. The John Hamilton Gray went aground about 200 meters offshore. It was just pulling out of Borden when high winds forced it onto a sandbar. None of the passengers has been hurt. Provincial Education Minister Jim Lockyer says it's important for people involved in the school system to know their responsibilities. That's a major part of a proposed education act that Lockyer has made public. He says it's important to outline the duties of teachers, parents, and children.
This is a statement of principle, a statement on which our educational system is based. And in terms of enforcement, as I say, this is not, generally speaking, an enforcement statute.
That's why Lockyer says his proposal contains no penalties. The war of words continues between Transportation Minister Sheldon Lee and some residents in the Kingston Peninsula. The residents who used the Romeo and Juliet ferry are upset that Lee has taken the ferry off its run. They say he broke his word to deal with the ferry on a day-to-day basis after Wednesday. Kelly Newstead of the Romeo and Juliet Ferry Committee tells K100, shutting the ferry down greatly increases the travel time to St. John from the usual 10 minutes.
Once that ferry goes off, we have to travel around either Westfield or Condola Point, which increases our travel time from 45 minutes to an hour. It also puts more congestion at Condola Point, which we all know is an issue right now.
And it's going to cost people in the KV more money to get rid of their garbage in the new year. The Westmoreland Albert Solid Waste Commission is raising the tipping fee by $3 a ton to more than $50 with tax. It's 12:04.
Take your taste buds on a tour of the Mediterranean. The Mediterranean restaurant beckons you for a hearty lunch. Choose tenderloin steak, sirloin tips, liver with onions and bacon, beef ribs or salmon steak, all with your choice of soup, salad and potato, dessert of the day, and tea or coffee. For a lighter fare, choose a Ben smoked meat sandwich, a Caesar salad or Greek salad, or steak sandwich and soup. It's as close as you'll get to the Mediterranean on your lunch hour. The Mediterranean on Rossay Avenue.
Good afternoon in K100 Sports. 8 games on this Friday in the NHL. The Leafs play in Phoenix. In Anaheim, it's the Ducks in Calgary, Dallas in Hartford. The Kings are at Buffalo, San Jose in Washington. In Chicago, the Hawks hosting Florida. New Jersey at Edmonton, and Vancouver plays host to Detroit.